हेलो चिल्ड्रन, आई एम वैशाली मैडम। वेलकम टू योर EBS क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विथ न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 12, चेंजिंग टाइम्स। सो हियर द लेसन इज गोइंग टू शो अस हाउ द टाइम हैज़ चेंज, राइट? लेट अस बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट पेज, पेज नंबर 92। माई नेम इज़ नीला भाई। दिस इज़ एन ओल्ड स्टोरी। आई वॉज अ यंग बॉय एट दैट टाइम। सो हियर नीला भाई इज़ गोइंग टू narrate his story and his experiences. My father used to work as a land laborer in the field. Now I'm spending a retired life. I would like to share my experience of those days with you. So Neela Bhai is going to share his experiences where his father was a land laborer in the field, and but now Neela Bhai has
long
retired.
Time span.
Okay, so it's now coming to the next passage, a big move. That was about 70 years ago. So it's an old story. About 70 years ago, Neela Bhai says, I remember the time when I was 10 years old. So he was 10 years old. That time we lived in Tando village of Aliyar, now which is in Pakistan. At that time, we suffered a lot. There was a lot of hustle bustle. I could not understand what was happening. One day, father told us that we had to leave our village and move to another place. So it is maybe during the time of partition between India and Pakistan. Okay, so they had to shift from that village and move to another village. Now coming on page number 93. I was sad to leave my village and my house. So Neela Bhai was not liking the idea of leaving the house, but then he had to because he was a very small child. That was where I had all my friends, because he had all his friends over there. Now this we already studied in the previous lesson, like when we change our house from one city to another city, we lose our friends, we lose our school, we get the new ones also. Similarly, Neela Bhai was also not liking it. We all moved with the family members in a bullock cart that too snatched at the border. So the bullock cart was also snatched at the border. Now border, I have already talked about India and Pakistan getting divided during that time, right? Lastly, we reached near Dholavira at Kutch. So this is again related to Kutch. So they entered the Dholavira area at Kutch. Many people from our area also moved. People were saying that our country was being divided into two, that is India and Pakistan. So previously, it was one country. India and Pakistan were in the same country, but then as we got our independence, we also separated as India and Pakistan. Many people from India went to Pakistan, just like we moved to India. For some time, we all stayed in a camp in a big tents that were put up in a huge ground of Dholavira. So when this transition was going on, some people were shifting from Pakistan to India, some were shifting from India to Pakistan. Similarly, during that, when Neela Bhai with his family shifted from the village where they were living to Dholavira, that is in the Kutch, they had to stay in a camp for a few time, the time till they were allotted particular thing. Okay, now coming to the next paragraph, a new home. One day father told us that we have been given some land in Karacharya village, Jai Ramnagar. He said that we could build our house there. I was very happy. So finally the government has allotted them some land in a village where they could build their house and stay there. Father and mother worked hard to make the house. We children also helped. So they all together made a house. And you all know that his father was a land laborer. So they were always hard working. So they themselves only built their house. Father dug the soil and we quickly fill the pans and pass it on to mother. Sister and mother mix the husk in it. Father constructed the wall. So this is the way they build their own house. We brought cow dung from the nearby houses. Mother mixed it with the mud and coated the floor. So have you ever seen the floor having the mud and the cow dung in it? Yes, this we can get to see in the villages, right? So this way they also made the floor and the walls of their houses. She used to say, coating floor by this mixture will keep the insects away. Now it was the turn of the roof to be made. Father made a frame by joining the branches of the neem trees and bamboo. We put old gunny bags on it and covered them with mud. Most of the houses around our house were made like ours. It was just our old house. I liked it the most. So the houses in the neighborhood of Neelabai was similar to the houses built by them. Now find out and write. Talk to any one of the elderly persons of the village. Visit him or her and find out when he or she was 8 or 9 years old. What was his or her experience and write them. So you need to talk to an elderly person and then try to answer the following questions. So what are the questions given? Where did he or she live? Name that place. So you're going to write the name of the place where he or she, the person you're talking to, lived. From what material was her or his house made up of? What the things that were used to build the house that you're going to write? Did they have a toilet in their house? If no, where was it? If they did not have the toilet in their own house, then where was it? The next is, in which part of the house food was cooked? Was there a separate cooking area? Where did they used to cook their food? That you're going to ask. The next is, a lot of mud was used when Neelabai's house was made. Why so much of mud was used? Because it is a kaccha house and kaccha house needs a lot of mud to be used, right? Then coming to the next page. Next page is page number 95. Changes in the house. Time passed quickly. We work hard and settled. Mother and father wanted me to get married now. So it is the time for Neelabai's marriage. I thought that before I get married, we should repair our house and build one more room. So now he was planning to build a better house. In those days, people in the city were using cement. Now this is a change that has come in the society. Instead of mud, people have started using cement for their houses. They say that this made the house stronger. We also thought that we would use cement. We used iron and cement for making the roof of the new house. So now the roof is also made up of iron and cement. Previously, do you remember how the house roof was made with joining the branches of the neem trees and the bamboo trees? Yes. Now the time has changed. So they are going to use cement and iron for their roof. So now it's going to be a pakka house, right? Now coming to the next paragraph. In those days, unbaked bricks, that is bela, were also available in the market. So the bricks lesson you have done in detail in your maths. So you know how the bricks are made, right? So during those times when Neelabai was constructing his home before his marriage, the bricks available were unbaked. They were not baked. So and they made the brick with it. The use of the brick was beneficial, means it was good. Now we did not need to coat the walls. Now they never need to coat the wall regularly because it was now a permanent house. Once in a year, we would just whitewash the walls. We also built a small kitchen in the courtyard. See, now they have developed. They have also built a small separate kitchen in the courtyard. The kitchen had a mud chulla and the place to keep the vessels. Now then I got married and my wife came to our new house. To cook, she used to sit on the floor in the kitchen. See, in the olden days, how they used to sit on the floor and cook and on the chulha. And now, have you ever seen your mama cooking in the kitchen? The kitchen has become a standing kitchen and she never cooks on chulha, right? She uses the gas, right? The cylinder stove, okay? Then we all used to sit on the mat in the kitchen and eat together. It was a happy time. See how they are sitting on the floor and eating their food. In the picture, it's already shown. So in the olden times, they used to sit on the floor, on the mat and eat the food. Nowadays, do we sit on the floor? No. Maybe if we have a big family get together, right? When only our close knitted family members are there. Otherwise, we sit on the dining table, right? So this is the olden times practice, which was actually good. Then some people used to get out to the field for toilet in those days. Some of the houses had a separate place for this. We also made a small toilet with unbaked bricks behind the house. See, in the olden times, they never had toilets. They used to go in the fields. But then, in this example, they have got a small toilet in their house. They have made it out of the bricks. Now, more changes. My 7 sons and a daughter were born in that house. So, he had 7 sons and a daughter. Time passed. The children completed their studies. 20 years ago, our daughter Zami got married and moved to Rafu village. When my son Lakha got married, we felt that we should get the house ready for the new bride. So now when his elder son Lakha got married, it was again the time to build the house, to renovate the house. Then coming to the next page. Page number 96. Can you see a nice big house? Yes. By then, everyone was using baked bricks. We also used them for the walls. And instead of the bamboo and the roof tiles, we used iron, grit gravel and cement for the strong roof. Now they have got actually a pakka wala house. In the toilets, we put pipes to take away the waste. The kitchen was made bigger. And now Lakha's wife is using mud chula rarely because she is cooking on the gas stove. So there is a total change in the whole family. Now seeing new things. My grandson is now living separately and built his new house. He has to go for shopping in the city. There the buildings are very huge. Many kind of facilities are found there. He is the son of the new generation. Of course, like, he is his grandson, so he has new vision, right? He built his house with the facilities like toilet, kitchen, etc., which are basic actually, which we find difficult to build up. So during the early years, it was difficult to see the toilet inbuilt in the house. But now it's a routine. It's very common, right? Few years ago, Lakha renovated the toilet and the bathroom. He used color tiles in his bathroom. Imagine spending so much money for a place to have a bath. Yes, but then we have been living in such style. But in early years, they did not even imagine of doing such things. I am now 80 years old. In all these years, I have seen so many changes. Even in my own house. So not only country, not only state, but in his own house, he has seen so many changes that has occurred in his own life. I don't know where my grandchildren will want to live and how their house will be. What are the houses like in Alleria's Tonda village today? And I also think that what would my friends be now? So he's just thinking about how the things will change and how the things would have changed with his friend also. Now it is followed with some question and answers. The first question is, which materials have been used in making your house? So you have to mention the things out of which your house is made. You can talk to your father and mother about it. Coming to the next page. Then coming to the next page, 97. Find out the material from which your friend's house is made. Is there any difference? And write about it. If your friend's house is made up of some other material, you're going to mention. Then the next is, what kind of house do you think Neela Bhai's grandchildren will live in? So you'll just have to think, imagine, where would Neela Bhai's grandchildren live in, what type of house? Then the next is, where would you like to live when you are grown up? What kind of house would you like? So what are your dreams about your future house that you're to mention? Then the next is, you have written about the material that your grandparents' house was made of. Has some of the other material been used in your house? Then name. So try to find out and write the answer. The next is, people are given names according to the work they do. For example, a person who works with wood is called a carpenter. If you're in your place, what do you call a person who works with wood? So they are asking about in Gujarat, in Vadodara, what do you call the people working on the wood? So what do we call the carpenter? Yes, in Gujarati we call him Suthar, right? So then turn the page. Now page number 96 is look at the picture and fill in the table. There is a picture given. We have to understand what is there in the picture. You can see that some masons are doing some cement work. They are mixing the cement. Somebody is carrying the cement to the top floor to build the slab of the house. On the other hand, there is an electrician who is trying to fix the electricity, and there is a plumber who is trying to fix the pipe. Now let us fill in the table. So as we fill the table, the first is mixing of cement and sand, that has been done. What are the tools that I use? Hammer, spade, iron pans. And who does all this work? What is the person called? The person is known as mason, who does all this work. Now the second is fitting of the pipes. Who does the fitting of the pipes? It's plumber. And what does the plumber use? Pipe cutter and pliers. And the next is number three. Although four options are given, there are only three different kind of people they are working about around here. Okay. Now coming to the next is electrical fitting is being done. And what is being used? Screwdriver is being used. And who does all this kind of work? He is known as electrician. Okay. So now you're clear. So now let us move further. With your teacher or guardian, go to the place where the building work is being done, where the construction is going on, and give answers to this question. So we'll have to visit a construction site, okay, and then collect the answers. So now it's not possible to go, like we cannot go together. You can ask your parents to take you if it is possible, or else I will just try to help you to solve the answers. Okay, the questions that are asked is what is being built. So if it is a building that is being built, we can write that. Okay, how many people are working over there? Around many people work when it is a big project, or less people work when it is only an independent individual house is being constructed. Then the next page says what kind of work are they doing. So they are all they're on the construction site, so they must be maybe mixing the cement, right? Like the mason works. Okay, how many men and women are there? Then the next is how many money do these people get daily, and ask any one or two of them. Then the next is what are the materials being used for making the building material. Try to guess how many trucks of bricks and the bags of the cements will be used for making the building material. Nowadays the houses are built using only cements, right? Iron rods and the modern techniques, and nobody is going to make house with mud and bamboo stick, right? Then the next is try and guess how many trucks of bricks and bags of cement will be used for making the building. So if it is a big project, they will need a larger quantity, and if it is a small project, not much will be needed. How do the material reach the building site? By truck or by hand lorry or any other vehicle? So list them. Find out the prices of one bag of cement, one brick, one truck or tractor of sand. And ask a few other questions and write these answers. So this all is practical based. We need to go and ask, which will be difficult for us in these days. So what can be done is I'll collect the information and get back to you with the answers. Now moving further. The last page of the lesson says over the 80 years, different materials were used in different times in Nilabhai's house. List these in the correct order. So you'll have to just get back to the text, read the whole lesson and try to find out the different materials that were used to build his house in the different stages of his life. Okay, so we are done with the lesson. You will try the activities that I have asked to, and then try to find out the new words. Thank you, children.